Alright, welcome back. So we beat Maleficent. Was there a world after that? Okay, hold on. Let's see here. We have not gone to the Dwarf Land, which I'm guessing is Snow White. So I guess that's our next option, is to go over... Wait a minute, level 2, level 1. Is this the reason why it was hard as balls, because this was level 3? Yeah, that must be the reason why, because it was not recommended for me to go there in the first place, but I went there regardless. That was not a good idea in hindsight. Alright, let's go to this world. See what Snow White and her friends has to offer. Trying to remember the entire story. Oh, I guess we're up into the climax or something. So she's fucking 14? I just found out she's 14. I think I must have said this before and forgotten though, but like I guess remembered or something that she was 14 years old. Okay, what's her deal? She's scared of this woman. She eats the apple anyway. Snow White, you dense little fuck. You dumb little fuck. There's blood in there. I can't tell if that was just the weird apple texture or if there's like actual like lead poisoning to the point where her mouth was bleeding, but Snow White, you're a dumb fuck, you know that? I mean, I know don't judge appearance by its covers, but if she's like walking to you so threateningly with so much like, oh crap, whoa. Well, this controller almost like, it's crackling or something.
What has happened here?
I guess I know the gist of what the story of Snow White is. But, alright, so why, I forgot what was the reason, was the motive for her murder. Was it because
she was
the prettiest fair maiden?
Sweet as could be.
She sang us pretty songs.
So, bad guys are always evil, and good always prevails because they're pretty, right? Nah, that's not more of the story, of course.
About falling in love with the prince she met.
And when we went to work, she gave us all a kiss.
She was so full of kindness.
That's one thing I always had to criticize Disney movies, or at least previous Disney movies, is that they really don't develop their princes.
But how did this happen to her?
A wicked queen was horribly jealous of our dear Snow White's beauty, so she used her evil magic to change into an old hag.
I know it's a fairy tale story, so it's like, well, it's very simplistic and the motives don't really matter. The judgment is there, baddie. It's very clear who the bad guy is. It doesn't matter what the motive is, but come the fuck on. If you're really so determined to kill someone for their beauty, someone who just exists. That's like if I wanted to murder, like, Chris... Oh, fuck, Chris Pratt, what's his name? I forgot. The actor that played Thor, he's like a handsome motherfucker. That's like if I wanted to kill him just because of his looks. Oh, to be fair, I do want to kill him, that's just for his portrayal of Ghostbusters. It's a horrible movie, do not watch it. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not kidding about the whole bad fact that it's a horrible movie, but I'm kidding about the fact that I want to kill Thor. Or at least the actor that played Thor, like, he's a good guy, from what I've seen so far in interviews and such, but yeah, fuck that movie. Sorry, I just had to get that rant out of the way. I'm mostly saying that because, like, okay, we already know what's happened with the world of Snow White. Snow White dies because she's eaten a poisonous apple. So it's very clear that this was the end of the Snow White story. And I guess it was also very clear it was the end of, Sleeping Beauty story. Was that the movie? I'm gonna call it Maleficent because, like, I guess that's something I grew up with. Well, I still grew up with it, but it was, like, that's a weird word to say. Like, I grew up with Maleficent, except Maleficent only, like, was it out in theaters were like, what is with this happy music? What the hell? Fuck, really? Oh, fuck, I forgot no one's home, so... Oh. Yeah, I forgot no one's home. Hold on. Maybe that's good enough. We don't need to save, necessarily. Oh, yeah, there's a Moogle shop. Hold on. We don't have a whole lot of... Wrong button. Also wrong button. Fuck. We don't have a lot of... command decks to edit, do we? We got a lot of potion, slow, poison, cure. Yeah, not much, but at the same time, we don't have a whole shit ton of money either. Wait a minute, what about action commands? What do we have here? Barrier, cartwheel, high jump, which... Okay. That makes us have the ability to jump higher, yay. We need to go to the cottage. Yeah, this is some very unsettling happy music for someone who just got murdered. Barrier, cartwheel, and high jump. It's not letting me buy these, then again, it might be because I don't have any money, but like, if the fact I could buy this again, then what does that exactly entail? Like, I could combine these types of... I've always been, like, combining these types of things, but... whatever. So she's a magic user. Let's try fire. I don't think I have a fire yet, so... And that, I guess that's all I'm gonna buy! Okay! Fuck, wrong button again! God damn it! What do I... Yeah, thunder, I don't think I need for her now. It's best to, like... I feel like she's more of a magic user, or at least that's what I think, because, like, both Ventus and Terra have been very, like, combat-heavy, so I'm just going by assumption that Terra's actually magic. She seems very majestical, so, like, I'm not just saying that just from watching, I am kind of saying that just for her looks. But, like, from what I'm seeing so far, like, her magic abilities are amplified, and the fact that... What? Punish foes with payback. Oh, it's this attack. I don't want this. And not only that, but like, whenever I like use what's that thing called? When I'm using my D-Links, I think? Yeah, whenever I switch to like Aqua's D-Link, it's always like magic heavy, so that's what I'm trying to figure out here. I'm not really seeing a whole lot of that so far though. Just correct me if I'm wrong. Just in case. Then again, the fact that I've now enacted this new Proxy up to Queen's Castle. Okay. I give her a reason why she killed her, and a good reason why I'm gonna kill her back. Alright. So many treasures are nearby. Potion. Oh, hello. I think this is a good way to, like, practice my combat abilities, I guess. Ow. Hoping doesn't seem like it's a safe move though. Oh shit, I'm in the middle of a horde. I got my finish attacks now, the one with surprise attacks. I don't think that's bad by any means though, considering how. Oh shit, back! Ooh, did I just parry? Was that a parry? It looked like a parry for a second. Like, I was able to, like, block at the perfect amount of time and still be able to have all my recovery frames. As you can tell, I've been playing a lot of Street Fighter recently. But. That looked like a parry. I might be wrong, but like, yeah, blocking seems to be very useful for her specifically because she has that shield thing. Wait, no, that's a fire dude. Why am I using fire on him? Okay, that's bad. Okay, fire on him. On the other hand, good idea. Well, he's not really staggering much. Okay, I can still combo my fire as long as I don't. Okay, so like, two hits, and then I can use either Barrier Surge or Fire to deal if it hits you well. Okay. These guys are fire. It's probably not a good idea for me to use. Oh, I got Bubble Blaster. Oh, that's my, whatchamacallit? This thing, right? Yeah, that thing is slow. I really want to, like, upgrade it further later on. Oh, hey, leveled up. Defense increased. Hold on, let me check something real quickly. I forgot, I have the ability to do this. Might as well. Threat's balance boost. It seems like it actually amplifies it more, so it's probably best to have fairies and stars. Stock. Fleeting crystal. I don't have a whole lot though, so I might have to like grind for these items. Just in case. I think this won't really matter too much until, like, the end game, because, like, in Terra's and Ventus' story, I wasn't able to, like, have too much of a trouble dealing with enemies and such. Maybe Terra more so, but, like, I'm sorry, maybe Ventus more so, because I found his story pretty much completely easy, with the exception of, like, maybe the final boss, but it's more, like, I was, like, I think at the right level to deal with that and beat him. Whereas with Terra, it's just because I'm underleveled. And I kind of got overleveled, and with which phase that made the final boss a lot less fun. So I need to, like, make sure, like, there's a way for me to, like, grind so that I'm properly ready for the next boss battle. But I'm not to the point where I'm overleveled and I can easily kill the boss battle. That's something I really don't want to do. I want to make sure, like, I deal the boss battle, but into my own. Fuck, that's a. Oh, that kills him. Okay, that's fine. I want to make sure that I deal with the boss battle at the recommended level. Not necessarily at the level which it's gonna be an easy breeze or where it's gonna be so much of a challenge that I'm just gonna die in almost every one hit. Or at least, like, if I'm gonna die in one hit, at least makes it, like, simplified enough so that I can dodge the enemy's attacks properly. Here, gotcha. I think this is gonna be overkilling, but okay. Yeah, especially if they're like already dead. Alright. I'm a little bit scared to go through these treasure chests. I feel like most of them might be traps. But let's just go for it anyways. Okay, a hunger crystal. That's something I could combine in order to melt items. Was there another treasure chest here too, or... I don't think there's anything else. Alright. So, was the evil queen that old woman? Or was she just a henchman? Again, like, never watched Snow White as a kid, so I know the story, I just don't know the full, full story, I guess.
This castle, it's different somehow. And I can't find the princess or hear her beautiful voice. Was it all a dream?
No, the princess is at another castle, dude.
You mean you know Snow White?
Oh, yes. We met once. It was a song that drew us together. Has something happened to the princess?
Was that ever established to the movie as well? Because from what I remember, there were, complaints about,
tricked her into eating a poisoned apple.
I must go to her. Where is she?
In the woods, guarded by 7 kind dwarves.
I will find her. Perhaps there's a way I can help.
I mean, she's dead. I don't think any resurrection spell. Well, again, it's a fairy tale. I don't want to ruin kids' dreams. That's also another argument I'd like to point out. Why do people assume because I say something's for kids, or necessarily targeted for kids, automatically assume that's a bad thing? I used to be a kid. I enjoy kid things. I still have fond memories of Power Rangers and Spider-Man and all that good shit. My childhood also consisted of a lot of Embrace games too, which is definitely not kid friendly though. But in terms of actual kid friendly stuff, I grew up with Zelda. Zelda is pretty kid friendly up until Twilight Princess. So it's I still enjoy kid stuff. I'm not necessarily sure why people would complain and say kid things just because I say something's kid stuff. Also, I think I'm supposed to go back there, but I get to explore around here. Hold on. Maybe there's a special cutscene that'll happen when I just go back, so. But the actual goal point is supposedly over there. But the game's not really restricting me to not do that, so. Yes, I guess not. Let's save real quickly. Okay. All right then. Let's go back just in case. Cause I get the feeling it might be another cutscene though, even though we're just gonna go back and forth and backtrack a lot. That's probably my idea as to how this game's gonna pretty much go through. But yeah, back to kid stuff. This, just because something's targeted to kids or something is kid friendly doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad thing. People like to assume that because it's a kid's thing, it's only kids can enjoy it. That's not necessarily true whatsoever. There's a lot of adults that enjoy Kingdom Hearts. I'm an adult and I still enjoy the series. So it's even if it is geared towards kids, it's pretty kid friendly in terms of graphics, aesthetics, story, and gameplay. That still doesn't mean any other person could not enjoy it. That's always mystified me. That's also the complaints I keep hearing when it comes to Nintendo stuff. Because people don't like Nintendo simply for the fact that it's kid stuff. And I have to tell, why is kid stuff on you can argue where you personally probably are not huge fans of anything that's kid friendly. You're more of the vulgarity, you grew up more Metallica than Wham, or grew up more on Little Wayne than Sleepyon. I'm not sure if she's kid friendly. I'm not sure. I mean, she's saying Beauty and the Beast in my heart. Before, I'm assuming that's kid friendly enough, right? But yeah, different. Again, like this, mostly because this show for different folks. But like, just because something's kid friendly doesn't automatically mean that I hate it. Cause like, I think that that's like, you can not like kid stuff, but don't say like other people hate it because it's kid stuff, because that's not true whatsoever. Like, I still like enjoy some kids games. Rayman Origins, that's a kids game. I'm just looking through like my collection. I guess you could also count Just Dance as well. A little bit of a guilty pleasure though, but like I do enjoy dancing. But I do like kids games pretty much as equally as I do love mature rated games as well. Like, I pretty much grew up with Ninja Gaiden equal to Legend of Zelda. To be fair though, I grew up with Ninja Gaiden after I got my first Xbox 360, so... you could probably say more of that. I guess, like, that's how I, like, started maturing, because I don't remember playing a lot of M-rated games aside from, like, this one, like, cargo driving game in the GameCube by Rockstar Games. I think it was like you smuggle like drugs, and like that's pretty much it. Like there's no violence whatsoever aside from running people over. It's solely like a car game, and your objective is to usually just like escort someone or like deliver drugs to, like, I forgot what the name's called, but it's made by Rockstar Games, and I think it's like one of the only like Nintendo games made by Rockstars. I think it was also on the PS2 as well, though, but I'm not sure about that. Yeah, I think that's one of the only exceptions. Maybe also Super Smash Bros. Melee, considering that's also T-rated. I played it like when I was 7 years old. And I guess at the same time, you could also kind of argue Twilight Princess as well. Oh, no. There was definitely one M-rated game I played as a kid that was actually on the Nintendo system. That was Nowhere Heroes. That game was awesome. I loved the game so much. Like, it was like... you could also say it was like my first introduction to the hack and slash genre. That's when I just grew instantly in love with the hack and slash. I feel like hack and slash is probably one of my like absolute favorite game genres of all time, next to like fighting games. And but then again, with fighting games, you're kind of limited to like multiplayer stuff. Like, you can play fighting games as a single player experience, but I feel like fighting games are most enjoyed as a multiplayer game. With hack and slash, you don't necessarily have that same restriction, because hack and slash is all about like beating the story, beating the boss, and continue on with that. Shit! Now that I think about it, like, I pretty much grew up the shit out of like hack and slash. Ninja Gaiden was awesome, Bayonetta was amazing. I wish I grew up with Devil May Cry, because if I did, I feel like I would have loved that game if I was a kid, but like, as an adult, I didn't like the first two games. I did like the third game though, which is amazing. But like, I imagine like if I was actually growing up with that, because like, you know, like those instances where like when you're a kid, you pretty much almost enjoyed anything you wanted. Yeah, that's how I feel. Like, if I did play that as a kid, I might have actually enjoyed it. I don't think there's any cutscene here, is there? Can it be true her beautiful voice is gone forever? Yeah, I think I'm supposed to actually go to the castle. This was just for like bonus shit, I guess. Might as well just save again now that I'm here. It's probably mostly just for the grinding experience, but you know, just to be on the safe side. So anyways, yeah. Oh, fuck. Sorry, I dropped my controller. Actually, another, I guess, kid, like, when I say like not kid friendly games, I'm also referring to T-rated games. So even though T-rated games I feel are like more kid friendly than M-rated games, obviously. I still consider that as a little bit more like a growing up experience. I remember playing Soul Calibur 2, like a shit ton of that. Mostly because of my love for Legend of Zelda. But I think the first experience I got from Soul Calibur 2 was actually on the PlayStation 2 at Vietnam, like when I was like playing at my cousin's place. And he had a copy of Soul Calibur 2 and I was like, oh shit, this is a fun game. I really wish I had a PS2 instead of GameCube. I'm just kidding. I enjoyed my GameCube so much as a kid. GameCube is like one of my, like, is easily like a childhood favorite console. I know, like, most people like grew up with like NES or SNES. Me, I'm like more of a 90s or 2000s kid. So, of course, I had to grow up with the Nintendo 64 and GameCube. I guess that's also the reason why I couldn't get to play Kingdom Hearts as well, because I never owned a PlayStation 2 beforehand. So, like, and this game was like a PlayStation 2 exclusive only. I feel like if this game was on the GameCube, I would have actually gotten hooked on it, but unfortunately, Square Enix was still a pain in the dick to the Nintendo games, so. Yeah, they still had that rivalry going on. It's not like nowadays where, like, they're now buddy buds a little bit. Like, they're buddy buds with, like, the Final Fantasy and, like, the Dragon Quest games, but not necessarily much with the Tomb Raider and Hitman games, I guess. Never grew up with Tomb Raider either, and never grew up with Hitman. I'm pretty much listing up, like, a bunch of, like, franchises that I'm playing, or I played as a kid. Now. I guess, like, in terms of, like, just commentary, just say whatever you want. Like, it doesn't necessarily have to do with the game itself. Like, that's how Game Grumps were able to, like, fill so much commentary without, like, stopping, is that they just say whatever the fuck they want. They can talk about penis juice all they want, and it's still funny. But, yeah. But Lester leveled up. Perfect. Oh, fuck. Wait a minute. Which way did... Oh, shit. I guess you're disoriented. I can't tell how my original pathway is up or down. I might be going backwards this way. I don't want it to be the case. But hold on. There should be like a hint saying like where I'm going, right? Cottage clearing. So that's the dwarf's place, I'm guessing. And this is actually progress. If only there was like a faster way to like tumble roll or something. But yeah, if I was a kid and I was playing Kingdom Hearts, I might have actually enjoyed it because I loved Then again, I think the RPG elements might have a little bit ruined it, though, because, like, I wasn't a huge RPG fan back when I was a kid. Or at least not until, like, ironically, when I was at the Xbox 360 era. I think my first exposure to RPG games was Tales of Vesperia. And that kind of played a little bit like a hack and slash, but I think I was still like a Kingdom Hearts as a kid, considering how I played Vesperia as a kid as well, and I also enjoyed that game. So, yeah, there was that. This was, again, one of the first games I played. Not necessarily the exact first game, it was like more like the 5th or 10th game I played on the Xbox 360. But yeah, I love Vesperia to death. One of my favorite. I played that game, and the game was multiplayer too, so like, I thought, okay, I can bring my friends along as well, and we all had a blast playing. We finished the game. I was mostly the technical characters. There was one guy that's always the main character, Yuri, and the other guy who for a while was, I think, Estelle as a healer, but then switched to Judith because I guess she was his waifu. I played Guy when I was, when was the only time you get to play as Guy. But aside from that, I was like, I think I was like Raven, because I thought Raven was a cool dude. Raven is a cool dude, I like Raven. Yeah, our first RPG, I think, was Tales of Vesperia, and... No, technically, if you really want to get technical, I mean, it is a JRPG, but the first JRPG I did play was, in fact, Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. Which, I don't know, like, it doesn't feel JRPG-ish, but it technically is. It's like saying whether or not Avatar The Last Airbender is an anime. It looks like an anime, but, like, people argue against why it's not an anime. For me, personally, I just say it's an American anime, and feel like that's, like, specific enough to distinguish that it's not an anime show, but it is anime-esque, and it should, like, be counted somewhat as a legitimate anime a little bit. So that's why I say Avatar The Last Airbender is an American anime. Just like how I say Wakfu is a French anime, and how I say Boondocks is a Korean anime, because, like, even though all of them are not, like, originated from Japan, they feel like they should belong in, like, an anime style, so, like, I say it's a regional anime show. Western anime show. Well, technically, Korea is not Western, but you get the idea. That's how I personally feel when it comes to, like, anime. I guess the way you could also classify Kingdom Hearts as anime as well, but, like, I don't know, it has Disney characters as well, so that kind of, like, delegitimizes its anime-esque type a little bit. But then again, at the same time, the story is very, I feel, anime-esque. So, you could also say that as well. Did I grow up with anime? Like, aside from Pokemon, which I never considered it an anime show, even though it absolutely is. I don't know why. Just consider that Japanese cartoon or something. Oh shit! Don't hit the red. Right. Dumbass Aaron, what the hell did I do? Anyways. Yeah, Pokemon. I always consider that more of like a Japanese cartoon than anything. I don't know why, like, for me it just doesn't feel, and that's how I feel about, like, Dragon Ball Z as well. Like, even though it is anime, it doesn't look anime at all to me. It looks more like it's made from Japan, but it doesn't look anime-esque. Like, I don't know why. Is that weird for me to say? Because, like, I feel like Pokemon and Dragon Ball Z has, like, the same, art styles. Like, I guess it's just the art style that kind of bugs me a little bit. Oh, hello. Like, even though it absolutely is anime, it just doesn't look anime to me, because it's art style. Most of you guys have no idea what the fuck I'm talking about, though. I don't know, like, it could be just me. Like, whenever I think of anime, I think, like, Kill la Kill, Naruto, Bleach, Attack on Titan! Whoopsies. But yeah, I don't think Pokemon or Dragon Ball Z. Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a little bit different. It's, like, in the borderline of Western anime, but also absolutely Japanese anime, because it's made in Japan, anime Japan, but it has, like, I don't know, like, Yu-Gi-Oh! For me kind of has, like, that hint, like, it's close to being an anime, but, like, it kind of looks like it's a little bit of a Western anime. I don't know, I'm just weird like that, I guess. That's how I feel about Yu-Gi-Oh! At least the, like, newer season, or at least I feel it with the older seasons. The newer season feels absolutely anime, but, like, the older season for me, like, Yu-Gi-Oh! And Yu-Gi-Oh! GX, they feel a little bit like Western anime to me. It might be just because of the dubbing that I grew up with. God, I love that show. I honestly, like, whenever I watch Yu-Gi-Oh!, I cannot ever watch it in Japanese because I'm just so used to the English voice acting so much. I know it's made by 4Kids and usually their dubbing is bad, but, like, I don't know. I like Jaden, I like Alexis, and I like Bastion. Cyrus is an annoying piece of shit, though. and I forgot who the fat guy was, though. Chad! Was Chad the I'm trying to remember who Chad was. I think Chad was, like, Cyrus's brother? I liked him. Oh, is that a bad idea? I'm not sure. Oh, or is that, unless it's one of those things where I jump on it. Okay, it's one of those things I should jump on. Oh, yeah. I like Chad because it just shows his badassness. Oh, fuck. And I remember there was, like, this bully dude that was, like, Obelisk Blue that always, like, wants to be better than Jaden, but, like, he's not at all. He's just, like, one of those guys that, like, oh, fuck. Those guys that, like, try to be hip and cool, but in actuality, they just look like an idiot. He's, like, one of those bullies where, like, they look cool and hip, but in actuality, like, they don't live up to that expectation whatsoever. I forgot what his name was. But, yeah. I'm not sure. I think it was it can't be Osiris. Osiris sounds like a badass name. It had to be some sort of, like, I remember it being, like, a stereotypical bully name, but I don't remember what it was. But, yeah, I think I mostly grew up with the Yu-Gi-Oh! GX than the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Granted, I still love the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Although I will have to say, like, most of its anime moments were pretty bullshit. Like, I think, like, there was, like, this one episode where, like, Yugi, like, attacks a spell card and he's not supposed to do that. Like, he commanded a monster to attack a spell card when there was no ability saying otherwise that he was allowed to do so. Which looked like he was cheating. There was something up there, but I'm not sure how exactly to get up there. There's two treasure chests here. I feel like one of them's a trap, but regardless, I'm probably gonna beat the shit out of one of them. Yeah. Interesting how we jump from, like, the ESRB rating onto anime. Speaking of anime, have you seen that live-action Death Note Netflix trailer? Actually, no, by the time I said that, the movie was probably already released by now. Wait a minute, I have an idea. If I burn it, maybe. Yeah, I'm smart! Okay, so that's how I activate this. But yeah. By the time I'm recording this, the live-action Death Note trailer was released. Like, I don't like White. From the portrayal of the trailer alone, I do not like White at all. Ooh, shit. Like, Light was like, he was a maniac, I agree, but there was like some sort of like level-headedness to him. The Light in the Death Note trailer looks like a crack addict. He looks like he was like struggling with school and all that, and I was like, that's not being faithful, that's like, I know adaptation is supposed to be different and all that, but that just seems way different to the point where like, it's a completely different character, yet it has the same name. I guess there's also the controversy of being whitewashed as well, like one of those anime shows where like, and to a certain extent also blackwashed as well, was the role of L. Like, it's kind of a little bit of a sensitive subject, but to me personally, I don't think it's whitewashing if it was just an audition. Like, if the creators said, like, we're open to all interpretations, like, and they just have to cast this white dude as Light because he pitched the role perfectly, then okay, I'm willing to accept that. If it was more like an audition, it was like, absolutely no Asians allowed, then yeah, that's clearly whitewashing. That's absolutely stupid. Like, the only reason, the only way that that's, I feel that's required is if you're really, really need to look for, like, a white actor, like. But the thing is, this is an adaptation of Death Note, and Light Yagami still having his same name, Light Yagami. A white dude's last name is not Yagami unless he's Asian. You could argue that maybe he's half Asian or something, which maybe that's what the excuse of the what the movie's gonna be entailed, because like I know the actor for his dad, I think, is Asian.
Something's
but
not right.
Again, like, it's still stupid. The same thing goes for like blackwashing and like even though there's like no prevalent of this happening, Asian washing as well, where they're specifically looking for Asian roles for a character that's originally supposed to be white or black or whatever. Like, I feel the only acceptable reason as to why you should have, like, a white person act in the role of an Asian person is if, in story, it is justified, or two, if that actor is really that good, that damn good. I could be wrong, maybe the actor for, like, Yagami in the movie might be fucking fantastic or something. But, like, yeah, if that actor can really portray that role very well, then okay, I'm willing to forgive the quote-unquote whitewashing. But if not, then it's like, okay, you guys are just, ugh. Like, for me personally, I have no problem with, like, any race or any gender portraying an Asian dude. Like, look at anime. If you watch, like, any anime show, then, like, even, like, the original voice actor for Death Note, Light Yagami, was a white dude. I forgot what his name was, though, but and he was perfectly able to, like, portray his character very well. Oh, what the fuck is this on here? Oh, shit. I think I'm gonna have to find the real one, or do I just have to avoid the enemies? My god. Oh, yeah, I can't attack them at all. They just do- Oh, okay, so I just have to find the real one, I'm guessing. It's a little bit weird, you know, whole hard to, do so. Fuck it. Really? Thank god this thing auto-targets to the right one. Yes. That was Kira, not Kira, but whatever. Oh god, is this upside down? Oh fuck. Yep, it's upside down. Okay. That's gonna make things a lot more... Well, it needed to be! Ooh, that's a close one. Oh. So I tied up again, okay. Fire! Fuck, really? Where are you now? There you are. Fuck, is this thing again? Feels like it's an infinite maze. Maybe I just have to... Fuck, maybe not. Yeah, it's an infinite maze, isn't it? Like, there is no, like... It's always at the end, I feel. So it doesn't really matter too much. Right, I also have a dealing if I want to. I don't think I need that necessarily for right now. Fuck it. That works, I guess. Alright. But yeah, what was that going on again? Oh yeah, the whitewashing thing? Yeah. Like, I don't mind black people, white people, or whatever people portraying Asians, just so as long as it's not under malice. Or they saying, oh, because, like, no, the... Or, if the director's saying, like, oh, we don't want to see Asian actors in the lead role, then fuck that director.
The queen is gone, my service done. Adieu, O victorious one.
Okay. I mean, the queen, I'm guessing, was just successful in that, her murder scheme. Oh, well. So much for reversing that curse. God, if only there was, like, one true love's kiss that can reverse the spell of her death. Wait, no, that was Sleeping Beauty, wasn't it? Not like that, but it wasn't death, it was... What the hell is with the plot of, like, Disney saying, like, kiss the princess and... Is Snow White even a princess? She's living with dwarves! Why is she considered a princess, exactly? Was she born of royalty or anything? I don't even know. Alright, well, here comes Prince Charming with the necrophilia axe here. Hey, underage hack! Prince Charming, you do realize how old she is, right? How old are you, sir?
Princess!
Oh, that was easy. All I had to do is have one of you dwarves kiss her, and then she'll be alive again, right? Imagine if they, like, cremated her body beforehand. It was like, oh, she's fucked. There's no getting out of that predicament. Holy shit, it's been 40 minutes? Oh my god, I gotta... God damn it.
That's so sweet. It's just like a miracle. Right.
After this cutscene, we're gonna take a quick break. Because, holy shit, I think I talked a lot during this recording session. But yeah, I guess that's all the topics I wanted to share. Just out of curiosity. What the hell was this cutscene? Or when the hell was this cutscene?
Ventus, why won't you wake up?
Maybe kiss him and then he'll wake up. Is there a thing with Ventus and Aqua? I don't know, I was kind of finding more, like, Terra and Aqua more like a good couple than Ventus, but, okay. no point
You're
kissing him anymore.
Ventus! Oh, it's a miracle!
Was this a flashback, or...
Terra! Master Eric?
Yeah, it's a flashback.
Ventus is awake!
I was like, when the hell did this happen? But yeah, Aqua's a pretty girl. I hope to God she's not underage, but yep, I'm saying. She's a pretty girl. That's all I'm saying. Oh. Girls can be pretty, you know? What are you talking about? Boys can be pretty, too. And I'm pretty sure that is the case as well. Like, look at that dwarf. That is an adorable-looking dwarf. The big, bald head... The Rudolph nose. That's a one adorable dwarf. I forgot what that dwarf's name was. Was it
Every
Sleepy,
waking
Happy,
is a new journey.
Gladdy?
Maybe Vent left because it was his time.
Anyways, for the dealing with Snow White, yippity doo da, we got a treasure trove keyblade. Not sure if that's a good keyblade to have, but we'll see. In the meantime, I'm gonna wait until, like, it's been 4